Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. This is episode 747. 747 always makes me think of travel. I just want to note that we have some great spring seminars coming up. If you happen to be near one of these places, we'd love to have you come out and check out the half-day Power Excel. May 6th in Princeton, New Jersey, and then South Bend, Indiana, May 9th. St. Louis on May 13th, and then the next day downstate in Springfield, Missouri. Going back there, there'll be a three-day seminar with Mike Alexander in Dallas. That's the 21st, 22nd, and 23rd of May. Then going to Trinidad. Now, no matter where you are, wouldn't it be great to fly to Trinidad to come and see the Power Excel seminar? Go ahead and try and sell that one to your boss. Akron, Ohio on the 20th, and then back to the Gleacher Center in Chicago on June 23rd. For details on any of these, just go to Mr. Excel. It's always near the top fold of the page. See a list of upcoming seminars. All the upcoming seminars are listed there, and we highlight a few here. So please feel free to check that out. Today's question sent in by Lucy. Lucy said, hey, I have a nice little spreadsheet here. It shows all of the sales reps down the side, their sales by day going across. And I was able to figure out how to use the max formula or the min formula in order to figure out the largest or smallest. But then, Lucy said, my boss needs to see which person had the largest or smallest. And she was trying to use index and all kinds of things like this. And I said, you know, hey, here's what we're going to do. We're going to set up two new columns out here to the side where no one can see them. So we'll have equal min of all of the sales here for Andy, and then equal max of all of the sales for Andy. And copy those down. And in reality, I told Lucy, you can put this out in column Z where no one will ever see it. And then what we're going to do is we're going to do a couple of things. First of all, let's use the match formula. The match function, we're going to say, hey, go find 960 within this column of largest values. Comma zero, that says we want an exact match. And what it's going to say that that sale, $960, is on the fifth row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There it is on the fifth row. So that tells us that was sold by Kat. Well, now to take that and actually change it to a name, we're going to wrap the index function around the outside. Equal index, and we're going to index these names, comma, and basically we have to tell it what row number we want. Well, what the row number is the result of the match. In this case, we can leave off the column number since there's only one column. We do need a closing parenthesis, and you'll see that that gives us Kat was the person with the largest. Now, to do the min, we'll use equal index. Again, the same list of names. This time, though, which row do we want? Well, we want the match of the smallest number, so this 53, within this column over here. Again, a zero to say that we want an exact match, close parentheses twice. So we can see that Kat had the largest sale and Matt had the smallest sale. Now let's just put in some new numbers here. Equal RAND between, let's say, 50 and 900. Okay, now in this case, the largest sale was 891 and that was Andy. So sure enough, Andy had the 891. Smallest sale was 50 and that came from Amber. Sure enough, there it is. So, very flexible set of formulas. The trick, though, is that we have to hide out here to the right-hand side some columns with min and max, so that we were able to use the match function to locate which person had that particular min or max. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.